Hello guys, my name is Yash. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. In this video, we will learn about abstraction in Java. We will also learn about Java abstract classes and methods with the help of examples. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. Also, if you have not subscribed to my channel, please subscribe so that you don't miss any updates. Abstraction is an important concept of object-oriented programming that allows us to hide unnecessary details and only show the needed information. Abstraction is a process of hiding the implementation details and showing only functionality to the user. A practical example of abstraction can be a phone call. You don't know the internal processing. Abstraction lets you focus on what the object does instead of how it does it. The abstract class in Java cannot be instantiated. We use the abstract keyword to declare an abstract class. It can have abstract and non-abstract methods. For example, a method that doesn't have its body is known as an abstract method. We use the same abstract keyword to create abstract methods. For example, if a class contains an abstract method, then the class should be declared abstract. Otherwise, it will generate an error. Though abstract classes cannot be instantiated, we can create subclasses from it. We can then access members of the abstract class using the object of the subclass. For example, in this example, we have created an abstract class named abstest. The class contains a regular method display. We have created the test class that inherits the abstract class. Notice the statement. Here, obj is the object of the child class test. We are calling the method of the abstract class using the object obj. If the abstract class includes any abstract method, then all the child classes inherited from the abstract superclass must provide the implementation of the abstract method. For example, in this example, we have created an abstract class shape. The class contains an abstract method display and non-abstract method info. We have inherited a subclass rectangle from the superclass shape. Here, the subclass rectangle provides the implementation for the abstract method display. We then used the object obj of the rectangle class to call methods display and info. An abstract class can have constructors like the regular class. And we can access the constructor of an abstract class from the subclass using the super keyword. For example, here we have used the super method inside the constructor of car to access the constructor of the vehicle. Note that the super should always be the first statement of the subclass constructor. If you want to learn more about super keyword, I have already created a video on it. Link is provided in description. If you like this video, share it with your friends and also don't forget to like.